This is my 1974 Volkswagen bus. It's got a charge maintainer on it. Basically what that does is just keeps the batteries topped off. And it's got a charger from the battery and alternator to keep the batteries charged. I think the coolest thing about this car is the pop top. It's awesome. It creates another room, basically. And it's cool. You can open the tent on all three sides and have a nice view of the water. That turns into a bed, so it sleeps 2 to 3 comfortably, maybe 4, if you know them well enough. Got a brand new rebuilt Porsche 914. For all my battery isolator wires. It's fairly clean. Fairly clean under there. It's got a lot more power than the old engine. I think the old engine was 1600 cc. I think it was a Beetle engine. So this here. Can't really see it. Lincoln. Here it is. I got my 1500 watt power inverter. The thing's a monster. It does what I need it to do, and I'll probably handle a coffee maker too. But these batteries, what I'm most proud of, the most expensive part of the whole thing, is two 200 amp hour batteries. So I got 400 amp hours. I calculated that my TV would probably run for about an hour with a 10 amp hour battery. But this one on 200 amp hours, I should get 15 hours without even charging. But what I've also got is this isolator, because when the car has reached a certain charging value, once it goes up to above 12.9, it starts to trickle charge these batteries. And then I have my maintainer there. So it's pretty well taken care of. It's got a Webasto heater. Right there are the controls for it, and I got a lot of crap in here right now, but the Webasto heater comes out of there, so you basically don't have to go Volkswagen cold. I know everybody knows with these cars, the heaters are awful. They were never right. So now I've got a big rig heater in here, and it runs beautifully.